I'm Dan Tranel. I'm the director of the Neuroscience PhD program at the University of Iowa. I came to Iowa in 1979, in August of 1979, to get my PhD here. I got my PhD in clinical neuropsychology, and I've been here ever since, so for more than 40 years at the University of Iowa. I work as a clinical neuropsychologist, and I run a research program in cognitive neuroscience, and I train students, and training students is the favorite part of my job. I've been doing that for decades and have trained close to 60 PhD students at the University of Iowa. I am the director of the program, and what I would like to do is share with you some of the things that I consider distinctive strengths of our program here at the University of Iowa. First of all, we have a nationally ranked neuroscience program. We have one of the top neuroscience programs in the country. It's also one of the best PhD programs at the University of Iowa. Our program is very interdisciplinary. That word is in the title of the program, but it's really it's very remarkably interdisciplinary on our campus. We have faculty from across many colleges and departments at the university, ranging from biochemistry to philosophy to neurology to psychology to psychiatry. And our program is notable for the interdisciplinary collaborations among the faculty at the University of Iowa. We also have about 100 faculty, so many different faculty with many different types of research at all levels of neuroscience. The faculty are distinctive because about half of our faculty are actually clinician scientists. Many of these are MD PhDs who both have a clinical practice, for example, working with neurological or psychiatric patients, and also run a basic science lab that has the basic science that's connected to the types of neurological or psychiatric problems that they're dealing with. This creates many opportunities for students to, you know, literally see the patients with the diseases that we're studying in the field of neuroscience. It's a very distinctive part of our program. We have a flagship course in our curriculum called the Neurobiology of Disease, where we feature kind of a bench to bedside approach to studying neurological and psychiatric disease. A lot of institutions have been expanding their neuroscience and have been investing resources in neuroscience, and Iowa is no different. We have done that, but it's important to emphasize that at Iowa this has been a real investment. I can give you a number, actually. We a couple of years ago we created the Iowa Neuroscience Institute and endowed that with $45 million, which is dedicated to hiring new faculty, creating new resources to catalyze neuroscience training and neuroscience research on our campus. We've built a new building on the medical campus that's dedicated to neuroscience. We have a lot of new core facilities and all of the state-of-the-art resources that are important for doing cutting-edge research in neuroscience. The INI has helped promote the hiring of many new faculty. We've hired close to 20 new faculty in the last several years. So these are, many of these are junior or mid-level, mid-career people who are going gangbusters with their research and who are looking for students to train in their labs and are very keen on matriculating top-notch students so they can train graduate students. This has greatly expanded our program. We've had in the time that I've been running the program, which goes back to 2000, so for more than 20 years now, we've gone from matriculating class sizes from in the range of 6 or 7 or 8 in a typical year to almost double that in the last several years. We have an NIH-supported training grant, a T32, that supports training of early first and second year neuroscience graduate students. Training grants are important not only because of the support they provide, but also because they keep you in the national conversation in terms of training students. So you literally get peer review at a national level of your curriculum, of your metrics for training students. And it keeps you on the cutting edge of best practices in terms of training graduate students. And we've had that training grant for decades, and it's been renewed several times under my direction. And like I said, it keeps us right in the national conversation for best practices of training students. I should mention that the compensation package that we provide is another distinctive feature of our program. We have a nationally competitive stipend that's currently at $30,500. We typically raise it by $500 or $1,000 each year. That puts us kind of in the middle of the pack in terms of a stipend. It's important to note that we add health insurance, we pay tuition and fees in addition to that, and the compensation package altogether is close to $50,000 a year per student. It's also important to note that this is Iowa City, and that $50,000 goes a lot farther here than it does in big cities and in many other places, probably just about any other place that one could live. That allows students to do very well, to live off their stipend. Students buy houses, students can actually, you know, live like regular people and not at the poverty line with the cost of living being very low in our community. And a very important feature or attribute of our program, one that I've been committed to in the two decades that I've run the program, is that our program is student-centered. It's a student-centric program in every possible way. When I took over the program in 2000, I made a commitment to that priority of having the students. The program is run by the students in large part. The students have a voice in all of the major committees of the program. The students participate in decision making. They participate in, in the evolution of our curriculum, in the evolution of the comprehensive exam, in how we set metrics and timetables. The well-being of students is a priority. As a director, I've made a commitment to this, and I think that commitment is disseminated down through the structure of the program. The students know this. We pay a lot of attention to student health, both physical and mental health. We have a student wellness committee, and we spend a lot of time on well-being, camaraderie, outreach, involving students in all aspects of the program. The students are the program at Iowa. Having that kind of a approach has created a lot of cohesiveness and camaraderie amongst the students. The students are friends with each other. They spend time together. They know each other well. Despite the fact that the program is interdisciplinary, the students do spend a lot of time together, and they are each other's colleagues and friends and sources of advice and sources of support when things get tough, and all of those things. I've been impressed at how the students have banded together during the COVID pandemic in the last 8 months to have, Zoom meetings with each other and spend time together as best as possible in safe ways during our current pandemic times. Another area that I want to emphasize that is distinctive about our program is diversity. to expand on that term, I want to call this diversity, equity, and inclusion. And I just want to make this point that diversity is a challenge in a place like Iowa. I took this challenge on head on when I took over the program in 2000 and have made that a top priority, and we've had success with it. We have gone from no diversity in our program 20 years ago to having a third of our students classify as diverse students. A third. And this is at Iowa. That's a track record that would be impressive in big cities. And in a place like Iowa, it's especially impressive, and it reflects our commitment to the goal of diversity, equity, and inclusion. I want to mention the chemistry or culture of our program. We have, you know, and the we starts with me and again disseminates down through the ranks, through the faculty and the students. You know, we've really fostered a culture here of a friendly, first name, low-key kind of approach with a good work-life balance, but done in a major place, a Big Ten university with a major hospital. So we have a big league place, we have big league faculty, we have big league grants, big league resources, but it's a small town. It's not a place for prima donnas. It's a place for friendly, regular people who have good work-life balance. And we talk about that, we promote that, and I've promoted that kind of approach, that kind of chemistry. I have picnics and hayrack rides and horseback riding at my farm in Iowa, where we're actually sitting right now out in the open, beautiful Iowa countryside. And promoting that approach, you know, year after year, students who resonate to that approach are the ones who tend to come here. And that creates a student cohort that has that kind of chemistry. So we have students who are healthy, involved, engaged. They get the Kool-Aid. They get the approach that we're using in terms of mixing top quality with a friendly, small-town, low-key approach to things. When we promote our program and tell people about it, we have two main goals, actually. One is to get your attention and tell you about our program in a way that will make you think, this would be a great neuroscience program. I'm very interested in exploring this program, interviewing at this program, getting to know the faculty, and potentially going to graduate school in neuroscience at the University of Iowa. There's another reason. Even if you don't do that, we want you to go back to your place and tell people that Iowa has a fantastic neuroscience program. They have a lot of great things going on there. And tell other people, think about Iowa. It's not maybe the first place you would think of for a lot of things, but we do have a great program here, and we want you to take that news back to where you come from.